Hello, anyone and everyone. I am Echo, and today we're exploring Obduction. We're back here in Hunrath, where in the last episode I managed to somehow, luckily, figure out that, I remembered the stupid button and everything, and figured out a way to turn the platform thingy around, and so now I'm gonna go and do that, because, you know what, let's go the other way. Let's use the other teleporter, because that one should be closer to where we want to go in Kaptar. And then that teleporter there, in Farley's house, is closer to where we want to be in Hunrath when we come back. I think, maybe. Or maybe we could just use this one. I don't know. Anyway, oh crap! No, we have to go down. Oh yeah, 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 yeah. Yeah, it is. It is honestly hard keeping track. Maybe not for other people. Maybe I'm just a little bit on the dumb side. Who knows? But it's a little bit hard keeping track of the map of two different areas and keeping track of where all the different teleportation sphere globe things match up with each other. So, yeah. And we gotta go all the way over there, and then, yeah, down this thing. Down here. To take us over the rocks, up these makeshift stairs. Or maybe those are... maybe these are man-made. I don't know. I mean, there's so many of them, and they so closely resemble stairs that I imagine the people who lived here must have set up the rocks in order to look just like staircases, but at the same time, they're not exactly neat or clean. They're not exactly well-kept, so I don't know. Anyway, point is, here goes nothing. Okay, here we are, and gotta go this way. All right, because we're all the way at the beginning. Great. Yeah, the game. Oh, jeez. Oh, don't do that, game. Don't freeze on me, please. Thanks for not dying on me. That'd be best if you avoided it. But yeah, the game. That's actually the second time already in this, so far, very short recording session, that it's tried to freeze on me, because right as soon as I used the teleportation sphere thing, it also froze again. So, yay. Alright, we gotta go. Jeez. This is gonna be kinda hard to remember. To go back down here, or no, we can just go up here, right? This stairway will take us like around the mountain and over to the big machine, and we've got the staircase shortcut opened up so we can go back there. Yeah, cool. Finally getting the tiniest of grasps on the layout of this place. Ever so tiny. Ever so graspish. Yeah. Alright, and over here, and then down the elevator. Hello, Bugman. Just gonna hang out there forever, huh? You know, close up, those bugs kind of look like lobsters, actually, which is kind of weird. I mean, I can't imagine what a bug that knows how to fly would need a, Well, actually, never mind. I think I just answered my own question. I was gonna say, I don't know what a bug that can fly would need with a a wide, like horizontally wide, flat tail end, but I remembered actually most birds have flat, wide tails as well, so I guess it's a bug that does a bit longer range flying than most other bugs. Most bugs don't fly all that much. They only fly for short amounts before they land on stuff, so I guess the tail helps with keeping balance when flying longer distances like a bird does. Yeah, that's what I'll say. Sure. Mm-hmm. It's my excuse. I'm just going to talk through this one loading screen so I don't have to edit it out quite so much. I had to do tons of editing for the last episode, so gonna try and keep it to a low, to a minimum in this one, if I can. I don't know. It's never possible to tell. I can't even breathe now. I breathed in some air freshener earlier, so now I feel like crap. Isn't that awesome? Yeah, sure is. But yeah, never possible to tell how long these loading screens are gonna last. But at least for this one in particular, you all get to watch it with me. Yeah, through the entire thing. Don't even know how long it's gonna last. I didn't even remember to look at the timer to before it started. But there you go. It's about to finish up. It's now switched to the Hunrath Skyscape. There we go. So now we just have to... Oh, we don't even have to run all the way back through Kaptar, actually. That's nice and convenient. Because we're just gonna turn this around. We want, yeah, we want that staircase up there pointing in the opposite direction. So, basically want... I think we should be able to watch it so that the motorcycle is on the other side, and that should probably... You know, opposite of where it was before, and that should probably, be correct. But of course we'll check when we're up there again to make sure. Okay. That looks about right as far as the motorcycle is concerned. So, let's head up here. Find the freaking staircase. Oh, I should have gone left. The staircase is on this side now. Okay, and... Yeah, that's over there. So... Yeah. I think that's good. Alright. Let's go back to Kaptar now. Okay. Yep, seems to be correctly aligned, and now, ironically, the elevator that we came down is... Oh, wait. Never mind. I was going to say ironically, because I was trying earlier to get the stupid elevator to let us step off of it before, but it didn't work, and then, yeah, and everything else. Okay, never mind. All right, let's just pick this thing up. Alright. And open up. Open. Yep. That's a good door. Alright, now does this lead... I think it does. Oh, geez. Frame rate, please stop. Does this lead back to here? Behind the machine. Like I thought it does. Yes, it seems to. Yes, this is exactly where we were before. So... Now, if I'm not mistaken, and I could be very mistaken, I think, since we've done that, if we go back down here, and if we go back through the teleporter, which will put the sphere back here in Kaptar, the big rock sphere, we should be able to get through and do stuff. Okie doke. So yeah, now that we're back here, and we never turned the sphere. So, if I'm not mistaken, wait a minute. Let me think about this for a minute. Yeah, because we never turned to the sphere, and the sphere was already in the right position. So now, even though the elevator is down, if we go... Yeah, if we go over to Farley's house and take that back, take that teleporter back, we should be able to go across and then... Oh, wait, actually, would it be faster to... I don't know. Okay, let's just go to the one in Farley's house. It's quicker to get to this one, at least, through Hunrath, even if it's not gonna put us out quicker in Kaptar. Oy. But yeah, no, if we go back this way, take this teleporter back to Kaptar, go over to where the machine is, and then through the cave, and that should take us back to the big sphere, which should now be in its proper place. And the elevator being down won't even matter. So, yeah. Oh, cool. Another quick loading screen. Still probably edit a bit of it out, though, because it... You know, if nothing else, there was a couple minutes... well, not a couple minutes, I mean. A couple seconds of nothing happening and of me not talking. And that doesn't exactly make for interesting content, does it? So for the sake of you all at home, I will cut it out. And, frick. No, the other. I want to go up those stupid stairs, because those lead to the tram. And the wait, no, we don't want to go to the tram, that's right, because the elevator's down. We have to go back over to the big machine, right? I already talked about this, but I forgot it already, because... Oh, it's really... And Kaptar is a beautiful place, and so far the puzzles have been pretty much perfect. Like, they're not super hard, and they're not too easy, but it's still a little annoying how huge and... I'm not gonna say it's maze-like exactly, because it's not... It doesn't feel like it's deliberately confusing in its layout, you know? It doesn't feel like it's really trying to get the player lost or anything, but... It is big, and it is rather confusing of a layout. And it's just... Yeah. Lots of different directions to go in. And the teleportation and everything makes it kind of... You know... finicky. Now where's... There you go. There's the cave. Now that this door's open, it takes us right back here to where the sphere was. And this leads back down to the elevator. And then this leads us up to the other door, which we can't get through because it's still barred from the other side. So what exactly did this do to help us? I don't know. I legit don't know. Yeah, let's go back up here, because this is the only other area that I think we haven't explored quite as well as the rest. I feel like we've covered all the other areas very thoroughly. But this one, I don't feel like I have, so... You know, maybe that's my memory playing tricks on me again. Or maybe I need to take another look. I don't know, we'll soon find out. But yeah, I mean, obviously, that putting the sphere back in that place opened up... I wouldn't even call it a shortcut, really. But it opened up the area in general to be... walked through much more conveniently. So that's good. when we eventually get that door open, that will certainly be useful. But, still. It's kind of, you know, kind of, I don't know, anticlimactic, I guess. Yeah, this is, oh geez, this is frickin'. This is kind of crazy. This is just the elevator that's gonna take us back down to the beginning area. And it can't go up any further, because I'm pretty sure the lever only has two positions, so it probably won't be able to go down any further either. That's gonna take us right back to the start. There's nothing else here, no other paths. Right. Okay, and this, yeah, it only has two positions. It's not gonna go to the right anymore, so it won't go down anymore. And it's not gonna wanna go left anymore, so it's not gonna go up any further. Oh, but that looks like a floating tree. That's cool. In the distance there, past the shield in the other area. Whatever place that is. That's neato. That's pretty damn neato, son. So neato, it's raising the dead. Yep. There's no way it could possibly go up anymore because the suspension for it is right there. So then, I don't know. I kind of feel like I missed a path over here, maybe, but not seeing anything. Nothing at all. Nothing over there. No. Okay, so then how about... Maybe down here. I mean, I'm pretty sure this is just, like... Yeah, there's a guardrail there, there's nothing, there's no path, and that's just suspended out in the middle of the air, so there's not gonna be anything down there. What if... Man. Okay, let me go back up here, because there's something else I want to try. What if there's a path that I can't see, because the big sphere, the big rock sphere down here, is in the way, because it's turned this way so that the lower entrance is facing the elevator, the stairs that go down in the middle, those are facing towards the elevator, and obviously that's convenient for our purposes here, because we're coming down the elevator, but what if there's a path on the other side that we wouldn't have been able to see, because I think even with the wooden, thing, which was, it had some holes in it and stuff. Need to go back through here. Oof. Okay, need to find my way back. Yeah, this way. This way, and go back through the teleporter, and go through Farley's house and everything. Pretty long way to walk, but oh well, I might cut it out. After I finish my thought, though. But yeah, because I don't think even with the wooden platform we would have been able to see if there was another path, because although we could see through the sides of the wooden platform, we couldn't really see through the floor that we were standing on already. So maybe if we turn the sphere around, since it has those stairs going down, maybe that will take us to another pathway that's hidden behind there? I don't know, that's all I can think of. So I'm gonna go try that now, and I'll cut out the long trip and loading and everything else for you guys. Alright, and we are back, and we're at the sphere, so we can start turning around to get it pointed in the opposite direction. Which, is gonna be a little bit harder to figure out than it was with the motorcycle. Or, I mean, than it was with the wooden platform. But, I don't know, maybe not. maybe it'll work well enough. I think this section over here that looks sort of like it was broken off probably wasn't actually broken off. That's probably just, yeah, because now now after having put the wooden platform there and then turned it around so it was facing the opposite direction, and now putting this here and turning around so it's facing the opposite direction, the motorcycle is right back where it started. And that means that, yep, here are the stairs that were originally on the opposite side, and this is exactly where the stairs and the wooden platform were as well when we turned it around. And over here, over here probably should be where the face of it is, where the elevator would take it down. That's a little weird. I was expecting this to be it. I was gonna say, like, maybe this is at the spot where the elevator comes down, because since this would be facing out to the, to the rest of the, facing out towards the elevator, it would make sense that this was rough and not perfectly smooth like the rest of it. Now I'm not so sure. I think this is correct, though. It has to be, because the stairs are in the opposite direction of where they were and everything, so I'm gonna say that's correct. And let's go back. And while we're going back, I'm gonna make a little point of something that I noticed I think that's very interesting. It's a nice little point to make on game design, is that, it makes sense purely from the perspective of keeping the player interested to keep all of these areas visually distinct from one another. Hunrath is lots of red rocks and human designed buildings. Kaptar is old crumbled ruins for buildings and lots of gray stone for the environment. And Murray is green jungle and colorful, like, red and orange plant life with, from what I can tell of the buildings, it's all, advanced alien, white-colored, sci-fi looking buildings and spaceships and stuff like that, as far as the structures go. And that makes sense, like I said, purely from the interest of keeping the player interested, keeping all of the areas distinct, but it also makes sense with how these teleporters work. Because without even really thinking about it, since I first saw these teleporters and started using them, I've been guessing where the teleporters lead before going through them by looking at the environment around the teleporters. And it seems obvious when you say it, but it's the kind of thing that isn't all that obvious for the for the game designer to do that and to make sure that the area around each teleporter looks particularly distinct. And it's not perfect. There was the one section where the rocks that led back to Hunrath, they happened to be surrounded by a lot of these things, and those things painted the area in a blue light and made it look like a completely new area, when in fact it led back to Hunrath and the opposite end of the teleporter just led back to Kaptar. And so, it's not entirely perfect, but even so, it's cool and interesting, and it's sort of hitting two birds with one stone, where each of the areas looking visually distinct serves two purposes. It stands to make the teleporters a little bit easier to navigate, and it also keeps the areas looking interesting, obviously. You know, instead of just the layout of the areas changing, since it's also the, you know, visuals of the area changing, it keeps looking interesting. So, yeah, it's just, I don't know. I like pointing out stuff like that in world design in games and stuff, because it's important to me. Because stuff like that actually has a very large effect on how much I enjoy a video game, so, you know, when something like that is so much more important than it would be to other people, it, you know, makes you notice it more, I guess. So I feel like pointing it out. You're welcome. Okay. Now we're back here in Hunrath, where, oh, that's right, I gotta go back this way. We'll now go down here, and I guess go over to Farley's house. That should be the closest teleporter. Yeah. And also the easiest to find, because we don't have to navigate two of the shield teleportation thingies. I never even really noticed that's making like a low humming noise. I guess I've never, I don't know, maybe I did notice at the beginning of the game and I just didn't comment on it, so I forgot, but whatever. Anyway, this would be the closest teleporter back here. Though it's not exactly going to be close when we get back to Kaptar, but that doesn't exactly matter. Oh well. Let's go. Alrighty. Now we have to run all the way up again. And I think from here we can go up the stairs, because the tram to move us across the chains should be on this side. So that would be faster. Yep, it's on this side, thank God. So yes, let's go take this. And hey, it gives us another great excuse to go and use the tram, which has a really cool view. You know, I mean, maybe not everybody likes heights with rocks in the distance and mist covering everything, but I think mist looks really cool, and being high up while mist is surrounding you kind of gives you a feeling of, you know, like being up in the clouds. A little bit. I don't know, maybe it's just me. But whatever. Point is, I think it's cool looking, and that gives me something to talk about, to fill time with, so I don't have to do as much editing after this is over, and can just, oh, wait. That's right, we can't take the elevator, we have to go back down through the other place, so I should have gone in the other direction. Crap. Whoops. Oh well. This will still take us out somewhere close-ish by. I don't exactly remember where, but it'll do it. Yeah. It'll do it eventually. This... Crap. Where does this lead? I think this... Yeah. It leads over here. It's... Okay. Yep. It's on the other side of this thing, so... Alright, we wasted a little time. Oops, oh well. Still. Ultimately, just leads back to this path, which will take us up those wooden planks right here. And then that will take us to the other side of the gorge, where we can get to the door with the cave. Yep, okay. I'm slowly but surely piecing this place together in my mind. The mental map is even more important than the written one, but unfortunately less reliable. Oh well. Alright, now if I did everything correctly, we should be able to go in here. waltz right on through. This should be here. And no! There is no path on the other side. Damn. Seriously, damn. But this still... Well, that still leads up to the other thing. Great. Alright, now I don't know what to do. So that's cool. Because that turned out to be... bust? I mean, there's a whole bunch of different combinations of directions we could turn that sphere in, but I highly doubt we're gonna get anything useful from any of the other directions. I mean... I don't know. I honestly don't know. The other directions would probably just point it towards the wall again. So I don't think that's gonna help. I mean, I could be wrong, but I don't know. What I do know, though, is I should go back all the way to Hunrath. And actually, crap, no, the other way is quicker. Again, I keep forgetting this. The other way will not be quicker because the teleporter is in Hunrath, I think. I don't know, whatever. I'll figure it out next time, because I'm gonna end this episode here, and, you know what? In between these two episodes, I'll get the stupid sphere back the way it's supposed to be, turned around and back here in Kaptar, and then I'll... I don't know, in the next episode, I'll try and figure out more stuff. So, I'll see y'all later. Buh-bye.